Mount Ruapehu is one of our most active volcanoes, and we know historically that it's been in eruption since at least 1870. There's been over 28 large eruptions during that time and many, many smaller ones. Most historic eruptions of Mount Ruapehu have come through the crater lake, and a very common artifact of eruptions at Ruapehu is the production of lahars. Also, Mount Ruapehu is the home to two very large ski fields, so on a nice day we can have thousands of people skiing on the volcano or climbing, enjoying the alpine environment. This creates a hazard because you have the people and the volcano together, and this makes it important for us to monitor the volcano. The presence of the crater lake gives us a unique opportunity to see inside the volcano, as the geothermal system associated with the lake carries many messages and signals from inside the volcano. About once a month, weather permitting, we will visit the crater lake and collect water and gas samples. We've been doing this on a regular basis since the 1960s. Today this is carried out by the GeoNet team. We collect a large sample from over the active upwelling areas in the crater lake and also capture the dissolved gases into flasks along with water samples.
So here we have sample from Ruapehu Crater Lake. When we bring the sample here, we just analyze all different kinds of elements, and all these elements can tell us a part of a bigger story about what's going on just below the crater lake. So after we analyzed the water composition of the crater lake of Ruapehu, we look at the data. So in the graph here, we have two chemical elements from the lake. We have in red the sulfate and in blue the chloride. Here we can see there was really big changes in the composition of the both elements, because here there was a big activity, volcanic activity, and after it settled down, and here you can see there were not a lot of changes from the chloride composition, but you can see some relatively low but clear changes from the sulfate composition, and it was just before the hydrothermal eruption in 2006, and in March 2007 there was some increase in sulfate. So the graphs here represent two different stories. At the bottom of the crater lake, there are deposits of sulfur which are building up continuously. So when both sulfate and chloride increase, this relates to increased activity in the magma chamber deep below the lake. But if it's only sulfate that is increasing, when the chloride stays the same, then it is due to the disturbance of the sulfur deposit at the bottom of the lake. This indicates shallow hydrothermal activity rather than a deep level rise of magma. So the chemistry tells us what's going on in the crater lake, and any significant changes can tell us also that there is an increase or a decrease in volcanic activity. And if we combine this data with other data, we can make a decision on the alert level of the volcano.